want to find somebody to love, right? And then what happens? You know what they say, romance is easy, relationships are hard. We all know sometimes a walk down the aisle does not mean a fairy tale ending, but can we do more to make it to forever?
Yeah, marriage counselor Jane Fendelman says she can save
any couple
from splitting up. Any couple. All right.
But as long as they're both willing to work.
They have to be willing. We got to get down to the nitty gritty because you have a retreat, relationship retreat happening this weekend.
Right.
And so the first step, obviously, they're interested in reconciling if they're coming to you, right?
Right. Yeah.
They have to want to.
Right. This retreat is for people that are doing good and want to do great,
okay.
And people who are in trouble and really want to fix things, and people who maybe have even already separated. I see so many people that are still in love splitting up. It's unnecessary. It's really simple. They just need some basic tools to really fix it. That's why I have such a good track record.
Do you think that we have just gotten into sort of the mindset that half of the couples will divorce, so maybe that's me, or maybe that's... I mean, do you think we're accepting sort of that marriage is not forever a little too easily?
Yeah, yes, that, and I think it's such a dark maze that people just don't know how to get through,
okay.
That it's so frustrating and... their heart hurts and they just want to get away, but what they don't realize is they're taking all their patterns with them into the next relationship. So what we need to do is just really fix the pattern, because people who are still in love shouldn't split up. That's
right.
So sad.
What about cheating? Because that especially nowadays with so many different apps and websites and all that stuff that kind of, I guess, propel and push people toward cheating. Can you save that marriage?
Cheating is a tough one. Cheating's a tough one because when people cheat, they have a really deeply ingrained fear of love. Mm-hmm. When we cheat, so there's little ways that everybody sabotages their relationship. We all have those patterns we have to break. But cheating is kind of the tippy top one because it's a vow, you and me. Mm-hmm. Whether you're in a monogamous committed relationship or a marriage, it's a vow, you and me. But I have had couples. In the 24 years that I've been a counselor, I have had couples actually come back from an infidelity, but it requires a lot of personal evolution and growth, because it's a type of immaturity. It's a wanting your cake and other cake too.
Mm-hmm.
How's that expression?
Yeah.
I don't know. So couples can come back from an infidelity, but I can save any couple as long as they're both willing to work and they're both willing to be completely bald-faced honest.
So while we have you here for the next minute or so, talk to a couple who's maybe in a good place. What can we do to strengthen our marriage? What can we do to kind of remind ourselves? You get in the routine of daily life and maybe you forget what it is that I fell in love with or what do I need to bring to the table that my partner does deserve?
Like the courting.
Yeah.
This is crazy because right when I found out I was going to be on your show, I also got called by E! Entertainment and I did a counseling session with a couple on Total Bellas. It was so cool. And it's a couple that's doing well. It's JJ and Lola. And they're doing well. Yeah. They just lost that depth of connection. Like life gets busy and they're just missing each other. And so there's a... video on my website, there's a teaser clip, but if your viewers want it, just text me or message me and I'll send you it for free. And it's called The Bonding Exercises. And it helps couples really get a heart and soul connection with each other. And you have to learn how to, there's being and there's doing. And people have to do both. You can get busy, busy, busy where you forget, you lose your connection and you forget to court and get heart and soul connected. And you have to stop and do it. It has to be like it's like a precious plant, your sacred
practice
relationship.
And you
tend to it. You have
Absolutely.
To care for it.
We're going to have her back because there's a lot to talk about.
There is, but you still have openings for your retreat this weekend. Information on our website, azfamily.com, or go to janefendelman.com.
Yeah, two-day retreat. You don't have to stay there. It's just for the day.
Right. You don't have to sleep over. It's Saturday and Sunday this weekend.
And you're going to give everybody hope. So that's a really powerful gift. Thank you so much.
Thank
nice
you.
To meet you.